8 years ago, I thought I had a great idea for a video. I was a fresh-faced new addition to the MinuteEarth team, and I proposed that we make a video explaining what is a species. But then, everyone started laughing at me. Hi, I'm David, and I was MinuteHurt. But my fellow MinuteEarthlings weren't mocking me. They were laughing because I just proposed the exact same video they'd been trying to make for years. What is a species was MinuteEarth's white whale well before I'd even gotten there. Essentially, my idea for what is a species was to explain how and why categorizing life into discrete, definable groups is complicated, which is the kind of thing we love here at MinuteEarth. We've made a bunch of great videos about how hard it is to define various categories, from trees, to bugs, to moons. But in each of these cases, the initial definition seems straightforward. So we were able to start on pretty solid shared ground before leaning into why things aren't as simple as they seem. The concept of species, though, is different. There isn't really any shared ground to begin with. The most famous definition of a species was proposed by the biologist Ernst Mayr back in the mid-1900s. Species are groups of interbreeding natural populations that, for one reason or another, don't have babies with each other. But it turns out to be super hard to determine whether groups are actually reproductively isolated. So other folks have tried to define what a species is based on looks, or genetic similarity, or evolutionary history, or, well, it keeps going. These days, scientists across different fields regularly use more than a dozen different so-called species concepts. And that doesn't even get into how weird plants are about this stuff. Like, some plants can literally double their genome when they reproduce, creating a totally new species in a single generation, which wreaks all sorts of havoc on any attempts to clearly differentiate between species. So you can see how hard it would be to condense what is a species into a short video. Needless to say, we did not make that video 8 years ago. But I'm stubborn, and I didn't let this video idea go. And eventually, I had a light bulb moment. What if I made a video about a species definition defying case, like the red wolf? First of all, it isn't a freaking plant. And second of all, it's basically the poster child for the issue of speciation. See, there's a huge scientific debate about whether the red wolf is just a hybrid between a coyote and a gray wolf, or whether it's actually its own separately evolving species, or maybe it used to be its own thing, but that thing went extinct and the current thing is actually a new hybrid. But it turns out that that seemingly small story snowballs pretty quickly. Like, if coyotes and gray wolves can interbreed, are they even different species in the first place? Plus, since new academic papers regularly come out supporting the various positions on the red wolf, it's virtually impossible to tell a story about it that would not be immediately obsolete. Woof, what a mess. But I wasn't done yet. What if I made a video about subspecies? Like, since Bengal tigers and Siberian tigers can produce fertile offspring, they don't qualify as different species. I could focus less on dividing up different types of life and more on how we lump them together. I dug in. But apparently, in recent years, the number of tiger subspecies has ping-ponged between 2 and 9, because scientists can't actually agree how to categorize subspecies. Is it by geography, or genetic differences, or something else? It turns out that there's even less scientific agreement about what qualifies animal populations as subspecies than species. And in botany, ugh, not plants again, there aren't just subspecies to contend with, but also varieties, subvarieties, forms, and subforms. Anyway, my video explaining subspecies spiraled into a story structure that somehow involved an island full of gremlins and an earthquake that also had a weird substory about whether there are any genetic components to race. Yikes. My teammates eventually, and rightly, made me give it up. Maybe I'll eventually stumble into some narrative breakthrough that lets me effectively tell the story of species. Heck, maybe this video is that thing. One final note. A couple of years ago, we hired Cameron to join the team. As part of the interview process, we asked him to pitch us a video idea that he thought would be perfect for MinuteEarth. You'll never guess what the title was. Not every video we produce takes 8 years to publish, but everything we make does take a lot of effort. I went through the data and found that, on average, each video we put out into the world has taken roughly 250 hours of work, from researching and pitching, to writing and rewriting, to storyboarding and illustrating. And that's not even counting all the ideas we toss into the bin along the way. All of which is to say that making fun, rigorously researched, and free science videos is quite the process, and we absolutely could not do it without your financial support. So if you like what we make, please consider joining our Patreon community over at patreon.com/MinuteEarth. If you join us at the $6 a month tier or higher, we'll even turn you into a stick figure, complete with your favorite hobby. Here are a few of the stick figures we've recently made. We'd love to make yours next. Come join the fun and support us as we make awesome science videos at patreon.com/MinuteEarth.